Since the space age started back in the 1950s, we have been sending probes beyond Earth's atmosphere on a mission to answer some of the solar system's most tantalizing questions. Each planet and moon is remarkable in its own way, and over the course of the last 60 years or so, we have launched numerous space probes designed to explore these neighboring worlds. Juno, Galileo, Pioneer 10, the Voyager probes, plus many more have traveled through the cold, dark expanse of space to reach these celestial targets and send back groundbreaking data that is fundamental in answering questions about the history of the solar system. But arguably the most spectacular data is the visual data, the images that allow us to see firsthand what these mysterious worlds really look like. Although many of our space probes have intentionally and unintentionally crash-landed onto numerous worlds over the years, most of them were unable to capture images directly from the surface. Instead, they transmitted a bird's-eye view as they approached the ground. Within the history of space exploration, many successful intended soft landings have been achieved, however, providing us with the ability to look across a specific alien landscape like never before. Probably the most famous images captured from the surface of another world came from the Apollo missions, when Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin first walked on the moon back in 1969. These extraordinary black and white pictures were not the first time we had seen the moon's surface up close, however, because in February 1966, an uncrewed Soviet spacecraft called Luna 9 successfully soft-landed on the moon and sent back the first ever images of its barren landscape. These almost eerie images were captured after Luna 9 had landed in an area called the Western Oceanus Procellarum, which is one of the largest dark lowlands on the moon. For 3 days, Luna 9 transmitted never-seen-before images of its surroundings, revealing scattered rocks, the rims of dark craters, and our desolate moon's sharp horizon. At the time, the Soviet authorities did not immediately release the images to the public. But scientists at the Jodrell Bank Observatory in England were secretly monitoring the craft during its mission, decoding its signals, and later publishing the images worldwide for all to see. Since March 1966, 18 probes have attempted to plunge through the thick, hot Venusian atmosphere and land on the shrouded planet's mysterious surface. 10 of those probes successfully achieved a soft landing, while transmitting fascinating data about our neighboring planet's intense environment. None of the probes, however, managed to survive for longer than a few hours before being crushed and melted. This pixelated, black-and-white image is the first photograph ever taken from the surface of Venus, and was captured by the Soviet Union's Venera 9 probe that successfully transmitted data for 53 minutes in October 1975. You can see angular and partly weathered rocks dominating the landscape, many of which are partly buried by soil, and a slight glimpse of the Venusian horizon in the upper left and right corners. The most impressive images, however, came from the Venera 13 probe that successfully landed on Venus in March 1982 and lasted for 127 minutes before going silent. Venera 13 captured this 170-degree panoramic image of the ground around it, revealing what appears to be a smooth but broken landscape of rock slabs and dry, black soil. When it comes to Mars, we have been very successful in photographing its surface ever since NASA's Viking 1 probe soft-landed on the red planet in July 1976. Viking 1 was able to capture this extremely clear black-and-white image of the ground around it just minutes after landing, and then, just a day later, transmitted the first ever color image of the Martian surface. The slightly blurred, color-enhanced image was taken during the Martian noon and reveals a vibrant orange landscape that is covered with scattered rocks and sand. But it wasn't until NASA began to send roving probes that we really got to see Mars in all its glory, especially when NASA's Curiosity rover arrived there back in August 2012. Since arriving, Curiosity has captured over 700,000 images of the Martian landscape as it slowly travels across the rocky terrain. This high-resolution panoramic image was taken over the course of 8 days in late 2019 and contains nearly 650 million pixels. It showcases an area on Mars called Glen Torriden, which is a region that is located in a giant ancient impact crater. But it's not just magnificent landscape shots that Curiosity has transmitted back to Earth during its time on Mars, because the Rolling Science Laboratory has also captured amazing footage of dust-carrying whirlwinds called dust devils. This fascinating black-and-white time-lapse sequence reveals a dust devil swirling past small hills over a period of 4 minutes and 15 seconds. The Curiosity rover also managed to capture a short time-lapse showcasing a Martian sunset in April 2015. Only 4 images make up the sequence, but it was the first sunset ever observed by the rover in color, and was viewed from within Gale Crater, the place where Curiosity is still actively exploring. The last world on our list to be successfully landed upon was Saturn's large, mysterious moon, Titan. The probe that made the ambitious journey to the moon's surface was the European Space Agency's Huygens probe, which travelled to Saturn aboard the Cassini spacecraft. The Huygens probe soft-landed on Titan in January 2005 after a 2-hour and 27-minute descent and captured this small but impressive view of the mysterious moon's smog-covered surface. This is the first ever coloured view of Titan from ground level, following an enhancing process that provides a better indication of actual surface colour. We can see what seems to be pebble-sized rocks or ice blocks scattered across a dry riverbed. However, the liquid that once flowed here was not water, but methane. Space exploration is extremely important. Not only does it help to address fundamental questions about our place in the universe and the history of our solar system, but it also creates new industries and expands new technologies while forging peaceful connections between nations. And with every new image that is transmitted back to Earth by our amazing distant robotic probes, an exciting possibility is presented: the possibility to connect the entire planet.